Hey everybody, how's it going? Streamed in the last few days, but it's been really hectic and hot. It's been really hot here the last few days, so is that music too loud for you guys? Seems a bit loud for me. Excuse me. Yeah, I'll turn it down just a smidge. How's that? Yeah, I was gonna say the music's way too loud. That's better. Okay, so I was given a request by Sir Cabot himself. And this is what we'll be working on tonight. This is a female version of a face mask. I guess you'd call it a corbett mask. Whatever. I did this one today. So tonight I was thinking we could do the male version because they're not really that difficult to make. The string here, that's the only part that I'm iffy about, because with this hood here, there's no ears. So I might get this in the character generator and realize the ears are in a completely wrong place, so I might have to redo it. But yeah, that's what we're working on tonight. Okay, so I've got the mail already set up here. Has to be perfect or it doesn't look right. Two, I guess. And then go from here to here. That's the beginning of my face mask. Grab a damn standard brush. Put it on add. Drop my focal point way down, increase my brush size. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna bring these out. looks like. It's out from the face. Pinch brush as well. Same thing, we'll do a pinch. So it gives it, makes it look like it's been pulled in. See, the male is different than the female because his nose is bigger. So I don't know how this is gonna work out. We're gonna have to play with this. Oh well. Okay, so let's try. I need to get his. So it doesn't look so much like lips. Thank you. And I can't do anything to the mesh, because if I do anything with the mesh, it screws the UVs up. So I need to build out. Shaped differently up front here, so it's going to be interesting. You know what? I think for now, I'm just going to leave that. Come back to that. I think everything else looks okay, though. So we need to delete lowers so that it's just that. Okay. Here's the tricky part, because I don't know. Because I don't know where the ears are. Like, I have a general idea of where the ears are. So this is gonna have to go something over like that. And it doesn't want. Let's try it again. So I'm gonna have to say this. It's going to go over the ear, like, because you got to remember the ear, it's going to go in behind the ear, right? So this is probably the upper ear right here, so it's going to go in behind the ear. Still with me? So I got a brand new light, which I planned on using. The problem is, I've already got a mic plugged into my computer, a camera plugged into my computer. One other thing plugged into my computer, and my power supply isn't powerful enough to plug in anything else. So I ordered a USB hub, should be here hopefully next week, so that I can plug in all my stuff. And I got this new light. Help keep my face illuminated. I also have to order a new light for my up above me so that I can use my green screen. Okay. So now what I want to do is back and brush it. this one. Okay, so so weird. I think that's as good as it's gonna get. See, like, I can't do anything about this, because if I try to pull this mesh out this way, it'll mess up the UVs, unfortunately. We're limited with the genetic, with the generics. But yeah, I think it looks good. So, save this. Yeah, it's taking its time tonight. Hope everybody's having a good evening. I can't say too much, but there's some exciting stuff happening in the background, and I cannot wait for everybody to see it. I got my new fan in. It's a really, really quiet, like tower style. It's just off to the side, and you can't even hear it. It's all good, Frog. Yeah, Richard wanted to come watch the stream, but he's too busy adding stuff to the avatar builder. Other streamers or other guys doing stuff like this, and ZBrush always like export stuff really quick for them. For me, it just takes so long, and I can't figure out why. Gone over all my settings. That's what really kind of irks me. If I was running like a 5-year-old machine or something, then I'd say, yeah, okay. I just built this thing last year. Oh, there we go. Okay, so you guys have seen this stuff before, but I'll show it again because it's cool. Okay, so we're gonna go over to here. I'm gonna grab my map, which is my high poly that I just exported out very painfully. I always do a low res version first just to make sure all my settings are good. Up to 4K. sweating. So this is what it looks like once it's been baked. Okay, and this is a start file, so all my stuff's already here. So I'm gonna do what I did with that one. I'm gonna leave the center section and the strings white. So anything that's got a white, it's part of the white cutoff, is the engine sees. It's not seeing everything completely, so I'm going to do another bake, guys. Just noticing that. I'm going to bring this up to 0.2. And that should bring this up here. Hey, Danny Gray. Thanks for joining the stream. And the chat, of course. Like seeing people in the chat. Cabot must have fallen asleep in his chair again. Does it not fix it? Yeah, see, now that fixed it. See how it's gone? Now you can actually see it. And I think that's what happened to the female version. I might have to go back and do that, because I noticed, I'm like, why are the ropes on this one side so flat? And I think that's why. So I'm going to have to go back and fix her. Okay. So we're going to do red, and then red is going to be this outside trim here. Simple paint. There's not much involved in this one. Light. Okay. X. Obviously go back off stream and do a final pass on this stuff. I just like to show you guys the process. ropes were green. That gave them their own color. I think about it. Okay, so what I think I'll do is I'm gonna do the ropes green, because at this point it's really easy, because the color will only apply to where there's cut off anyway. So it's really easy to do that. Except it anyway, because it's... like mask. So this will be your first material when you're in the character generator. This is your second, and then this is your third. And then I don't have blue in this one. I mean, I'm not sure where I could put blue. I guess I could put like a nose strip or something. So you can make that glow, or you can add whatever color you want. So I'll have to add that onto the female. Anyway, okay, so I'm gonna save this out. And then we're gonna save him out as I can go in here, see if I can find the mat I used before so you guys can see. I got my mouse over here and it doesn't reach over here, so I'm having to look over. Okay, so then we go here and then we go in here and then we go paste content. And then we'll change color to white. To a lighter blue. And then the blue, I mean, you could do anything with it. You can make it plastic, you could put an emissives channel on it. Give it some height. Now, here's the issue with Substance Painter, again, is it likes to, for some reason, all my information from, say, this layer, it travels up the stack for some reason, and it shouldn't do that. So that gives you an idea. I still need to work on it, because if you look at show you what the female one looks like. So this is the female version, and you can see that it's the folds are quite more dramatic, so I'm gonna have to play around with it. And you can also see, if you look at it, she doesn't have this big gaping huge nose. So it looks better on her. I'll work on it. So yeah, I think that'll be it for the stream, guys. Unless anybody's got some questions for me over the last minutes or questions. I'm not really good this year. Got any questions? Thanks for watching, guys. I will upload this to YouTube either tonight or tomorrow. If you haven't, all my links are in the down there, so head over to YouTube, and if you haven't yet, hit subscribe and watch a bunch of my videos. Helps out. But yeah, thanks for watching, and as always, see you out there. Bye for now.